Golden Boy Boxing on Ring TV Live is brought to you by the Ring TV app. Download the all-new Ring TV app today for exclusive videos and articles from the Bible of Boxing. Download from the App Store today. Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, Abe Lopez, Joseph Diaz, and there you see Tino Avila coming into the ring. And let's see what he had to say to the Ring TV cameras.
I decided to move up to the featherweight division. I kind of made my mark at 122. You know, I didn't become world champion, but I felt like, you know, being there since I was 17 was kind of long enough. And I think 126 is even a better weight for me to prove my point that I belong in this sport. I describe myself as a boxer puncher. You know, I'm more of a boxer, and then when it comes down to it, I can punch. From my last fight with Rene Alvarado, I learned to pretty much stick with the game plan, you know, keep using my jab, you know, keep my hands up, and, you know, take the shots when I got them, you know, and kind of stay focused in the fight and not have other things in my mind. I'm always excited to fight anywhere, you know, if it's in my own backyard or LA Fight Club, you know, I'm always excited just to fight. But, you know, being in that small venue kind of, you know, makes me more excited too, because, you know, I get a little bit more of a fan base to come out here, you know, not those fans that just watch the big fights. Boxing means a lot to me, you know, it's, you know, pretty much who I am now, what the reason, you know, I could say for being alive, you know, it's kept me out of trouble, kept me out of the streets, you know, kept me, you know, safe and in the gym every day, so it's, you know, it means a lot to me.
Playing 10 rounds of boxing this scheduled in the featherweight division. Presentado por Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions y patrocinado por Tecate Born Ball y Casa Mexico Tequila. It's in the taste. Los tres jueces por este combate, the three judges score. The record stands at 27 victories, 5 defeats, 2 draws, and 16 wins coming by way of knockout. Presentando de Mexicali, Baja California, Mexico, Jose El Negro Ramirez. Y oponente en la esquina roja, con los patrocinios negro con plata y un peso de 125 libras y medias. His opponent across the ring wears black, trimmed in the flags of Mexico and the USA. He weighed in officially 125.5 pounds. De Fairfield, California, presentando el invicto. Here is the undefeated, Manuel Tino Avila. Once again, your referee, Dr. Lou Moret, with the final instruction.
Man, ya les di reglas que la pelea no es buena, buena suerte, pero al campeón.
Dr. Lou Moret, third man in the ring, who will win, Avila or Ramirez? A Twitter poll. Avila coming in, winning the Golden Boy Twitter poll. A poll that was open all. Actually, Ramirez went in there. There you go. Saw that. Saw Avila first. Avila was winning earlier tonight, but Ramirez jumps out right away. Beto Duran watching Tino Avila, a highly touted golden boy, 126-pounder. He's undefeated. Also undefeated, my partner, Joseph Diaz Jr. and Abe Lopez. So we're loaded at 126 pounds here ringside. I used to be 126 pounds, but we're ready to go. What do you expect in this one, Joseph?
I expect Manuel to outbox Jose Ramirez, create his angles, and use his range and his distance like he did before. He has good head movement and good defense as well, so I don't think he's going to be getting hit flush against Ramirez tonight.
Abe, do you know anything about Tino?
No, just from what I see in his professional fights. If he keeps using his distance and uses his angles, he'll do a great job.
Featherweight division is stacked all around boxing. Right now, Tino Avila in the black trunks with the Mexico flag on one side, the USA flag on the other, taking on Jose Ramirez, 29 years old from Mexicali, Mexico. He's 27-5-2. Three of the losses for Ramirez, look at this name in the 126-pound division. Vasily Lomachenko, when he made his pro debut, was stopped with a body shot. Abner Mares stopped him with a body shot. Then Oscar Valdez stopped him with a body shot. Ramirez has gone up against the bigger names. Avila hasn't. 21-0, his toughest test to date for Tino Avila, the fighter out of Fairfield, Georgie Dukes Boxing. Also representing Vacaville. Some blood or some redness out of the...
of his nose, right?
Yeah, yeah, for Tino Avila, okay.
Yeah, Jose Ramirez, he's coming with a different game plan than his other fights. He's being very aggressive with Manuel Avila, and I think that's his game plan, is to try to confuse Manuel and make sure that he's not using his range like he's done before in previous fights.
Abe, you know Ramirez very well, don't you?
Yes, I was sparring with him. He helped me get ready for my next fight. So, I mean, he was very aggressive in the sparring sessions, and I guess that's what they were telling him, and that's what his corner's telling him right now.
Yeah, trained by Yuka. Here's Jose Ramirez. They were telling him, you need to come out and be aggressive. That's what the game plan is. So in the first three rounds are where they're going to go after Tino and just smother him, which is not what he's doing right now. It's one thing to have a game plan.
Ooh,
right hand landed. Tino Avila. First saw him a few years ago in Del Mar. Single boy, no tattoos, no hair. Now he's got the hair, got tattoos, wife, and a baby on the way. Final seconds of the opening round between Avila and Ramirez. 10 rounds in the featherweight division. And let's look at the fighter bios for our main event tonight.
Age 24, hometown Fairfield, California. His record's 21-0 with 8 KOs. He's an IBA featherweight champion right now. He's ranked 5th in the American featherweight. His past opponents were Rene Alvarado, Eric Reese, and Salinas. He has a very good good background. I mean, Rene Alvarado and Eric Reese are very tough fighters, so he has that experience. The first round, I had Manuel Villa winning that fight. I felt like he was using his range like he's done in the previous fights, landing the more effective shots. But, I mean, Jose Ramirez, he's still swinging for the fences. He's trying to land a shot to hurt Manuel Villa and to try to get him out of there.
Sold out Belasco Theater in downtown Los Angeles. Beto Duran, Joseph Diaz Jr., who will be the co-main December 17th on HBO at the Forum in Los Angeles on the night of Bernard Hopkins' last fight. Before that, though, December 2nd here at the Belasco, Abe Lopez comes back to the ring, and he's the main event. Get your tickets early. Belasco always sells out, always a cool spot. It's a place where it can spring you to the next level. It's, as Joseph has proven, he used to headline here, now he's pay-per-view. Head on HBO. Abe, that's your goal, right?
Yes, yes.
That's everybody's goal.
Everybody's goal.
Like, you want to come back to the Belasco and be like, yeah, yeah, I'm going to sit in the crowd. And
yeah.
That's what Tino Avila is trying to do also, his third fight at the Belasco Theater. 1,000 people squished in here. Good vibe, just a great club show. see the stars of tomorrow today. Golden Boy Media and Entertainment bringing it to you on Ring TV Live. Keep the tweets coming. I'm Durant Sports. What's your Twitter, Joseph?
At Joseph Diaz Jr. on Twitter.
Abe, what's yours?
Team Abe Lopez.
Team Abe Lopez. You got a team? Woo! There you go. Also, Thalia is the fourth member of our crew tonight. Doing a good job getting the interviews. And Will Wright leading this ship for us tonight. Golden Boy Media and Entertainment. Make sure you check out the earlier fight from tonight, the Golden Boy YouTube page uploaded immediately. Check out the Golden Boy Snapchat, Instagram, and Twitter, led by Executive Vice President David Tatro. All of it, of course, part because of our owner and founder, Hall of Famer, Oscar De La Hoya. Second round of action, scheduled for 10, Tino Avila, Fairfield, California. He's 24 years old. Hook landed by Ramirez. Negro, as they call him in Mexicali. Trains to the Azteca gym.
Nice one, man.
So the thing that he learned from those losses to those monsters in that division was that you have to prepare a different way. As you move up in your competition, you guys know this better, right? The competition gets harder. You have to focus and get in there.
Absolutely. I mean, every single fight, your opponent's going to get tougher and tougher, and those guys are wanting to beat you, and they're training their butts off. They want to pull that upset, and they want to win to make the names for themselves. So they're training every single day just like you, and that's when you got to make sure that you're dieting right, eating the right foods, having the good nutrition, and training very hard, doing strength conditioning, and putting those hours in inside the gym.
Push down. Talk him right on top of it.
You could tell Jose Ramirez, he's been training very hard for this fight because he has great conditioning.
Yeah.
He has a six-pack, a little shredded. So, I mean, he's a live dog tonight. And he's landed some vicious shots on Manuel Villa today. So, it's going to be a great fight.
What do you see here, Abe? You know Ramirez.
Yeah, he got that left hook. But those clean shots were from Avila. Using the speed, what you need to do, hit and move.
Don't get fazed here, Abe. Don't get fazed, baby. Keep talking. There's people in your ears. We know it.
Stay compact.
Yeah, his opponent, I mean, his trainer's not saying anything to him.
Not much talking in that corner. Good, bad? Do you guys like that? What?
No, I think it's bad, man, because whenever I'm in my corner, I would like to have my father give me advice on what I should do and what I'm doing wrong, because going in there, I got to have a game plan every single round, because his opponent, his trainer is giving him more advice on how to beat him, so I don't think that's a good plan at all going into this fight.
Yeah, the coach needs to dissect the fighter and break him down and tell the fighter what he needs to do.
Beto Duran, Joseph Diaz Jr., Abe Lopez tonight. Third round is where Jose Ramirez said that he was really going to come out and attack and smother him. Said he saw a lot of video on Avila and noticed that he doesn't like when you're on top of him. You're going to smother him. He's never had pressure on him. If that's what he's doing, what do you have to do if you're Avila, JoJo?
If I was Avila, I would still establish my jab and dig to the body. Break him down a little bit more for you. He won't be that aggressive. Manuel Avila, he's landing shots on top, but he's not digging to the body at all. And those body shots take a toll later in the fight, and that's what's going to get Jose Ramirez tired. But I don't see Villa throwing any body shots right now, so Jose Ramirez is going to have all the condition in a row and still be a live dog in there.
And it seems like he doesn't even... Ramirez doesn't let Avila get his space to set off some punches.
Does he have power? I mean, he has 16 KOs, Ramirez does, but that's early on in his career. Does he have power?
Well, you could tell that, Manuel Avila, he has respect for Jose Ramirez going into this fight because he got hit pretty flush in the last round, in the previous round. So it seems like whenever Jose Ramirez is trying to be aggressive, Avila is trying to hold and clinch because he knows that he's going to get hit with a good shot.
And Abe, you know this, sparring with him, but it's different when you have the headgear on, but you feel it?
Well, I use a regular headgear. I don't use the bar type of headgear that everybody uses. I mean, I'd rather feel the punch, because it prepares you to feel the punch, you know what I mean? As opposed to wearing the one with the bar, it doesn't prepare you. So,
But felt some power from Ramirez?
He couldn't get me flush, so I didn't let him get the distance.
Good for
on
you.
Me. Yes.
What kind of guy is he to spar, though?
Oh, man.
Is this what he does when
he's
sparring?
Yeah, he tries to do that, but, you mean, that's why you clinch, you turn him, and then you push him, and then you set off again, straight punches.
That's that Mexican way, huh? That rugged from legit Mexico.
Yeah, throwing shots from everywhere. Throwing looping shots, hip shots, behind the head shots, everything.
That's and not that Mexican-American way, right? No, I mean, it's different because the Mexican-American way, you guys are brought through the amateurs and you're forced to not clinch. Yeah. In the Mexico, it's like, a tirar, let's go, a fajar, right?
Yeah, because when they're clinching, I mean, that's the referee's on the other side, so that's when you could, you know, throw your dirty shots, throw your hip shots, and throw your below the belt shots. Yeah.
Done with three. It's scheduled for 10. And Tino Avila does not want to talk with Ramirez at all. Ramirez is like, okay, I'm here to scrap with you, but Tino ain't having it. Beth the Duran, Joseph Diaz Jr., Abe Lopez. Now, December 17th, you are at the Forum.
Yes.
You have an opponent yet?
No opponent yet. We had a few names, but none have been signed. So we're coming to agreement with one opponent that's going to be a very tough opponent that's going to give me a fight of a lifetime, and that's going to be the toughest fight to date. This guy's very strong in there. He's going to bring out the best in me. So tune in, guys. December 17th on HBO, I'll be the co-main event. My opponent is no joke. It's going to be a great fight for the fight.
So when you're the co-main, it's not a chump. Somebody's coming in here coming for your O, right? They're gunning.
Yes, absolutely. I mean, Peter Nelson and HBO, they're not going to want me to fight a guy that I could just walk all over. This guy is going to be a live dog. He's going to want to pull an upset, and he's going to want to dethrone me and take my undefeated record. So I got to go out there and train hard.
December 2nd, Belasco Theater. What's on schedule for you, Abe?
Well, hopefully the opponent accepts the fight, and we get him signed and get to confirm the name.
That'll be 10 rounds for you, right?
Yes, sir.
Abe Lopez, thanks very much for you. You're going to go back and work the ring for us, I think. And it's just me and JoJo the rest of the way. Here we go. Fourth round, scheduled for 10, and it's getting rugged. It's getting tough. You ever been in a scrap like this, JoJo?
Yes, I have. Actually, with Rene Alvarado over there at the LA Sports
Not
Arena.
Like this, though.
No, not like this. Not like this. This is more rugged and more difficult. I feel like Manuel should be outboxing him a little more, be establishing the jazz, but he's not digging to the body at all, and that's what's making Jose Ramirez aggressive, because he's not feeling any type of tiredness at all whatsoever.
Yeah, you mentioned your fight with Rene Alvarado. That was one at the Fancy Springs. You ended up stopping him. You had to go work and work and work as the fights continue to progress here in the fourth round, and it's just exactly what Ramirez said he was going to do, smother Tino Avila. But it's one thing to smother, it's another thing just to get on top and mug this guy.
Yeah, I think he's trying to smother him and mug him like how he is to get him tired. Manuel Villa, he's putting a lot of conditioning. He's getting tired because he's holding a lot, and when you're holding a lot, it starts getting you more tired, because you're not using a laser or anything. You're using your whole body, trying to hold and trying to, you know, clinch up. And that's what gets you tired a lot more. And
you ever done that where a guy lays on you or tries to?
Yeah, because when they put their body weight on you, they try to get you tired, and it does get you tired because you're putting your own weight and their body weight as well. So it's double the weight, and that's what gets you tired. And that's what I think Jose Ramirez is doing. And he's being very aggressive, and he's landing effective shots on Avila.
When you're the underdog and you're the opponent, you got to do what you got to do. Forget that the crowd is booing this and they're not liking the style. This is something that you could possibly steal some rounds, as Doug Fisher joins us back here in the fourth round for the rest of the way. Yeah, you're watching it from a distance right now. What do you see so far?
I see a mauling fight, and that suits Ramirez. He's trying to wear out Avila. And when you're in there with a crafty boxer, a stick-and-move fighter, you don't want to give them time to think. You don't want to give them space to operate. You want to smother them. He would get more leverage on his shots if he gave himself a little bit of punching room. But so far it's not a very sharp performance from Avila. He looks like he's lacking something, some kind of focus.
Exactly. He's getting hit with some shots, and he looks a little tired, too.
Yes, he does.
Frustrated?
Frustrated and tired. I think he took. I think Jose Ramirez is taking Manuel out of his game plan and getting him frustrated a little bit. See, because he's landing low blows, he's throwing a lot of shots, landing shots behind the head and everything. So that takes a lot out of you.
I think this is Ramirez's round.
No, absolutely. Yeah, Ramirez won this round, no doubt.
How did you see the first three rounds? How did you score the first three rounds?
I have it 2-2 right now. I have Manuel boxing him the first two rounds, but after the third and fourth round, I have Jose tying it up because he was being more aggressive, landing the cleaner shots, and he actually hurt. It seemed like he actually hurt Manuel in the third round with some vicious right hands and hooks.
He was pushing him to the ropes, and he landed a cuffing right to the ear, another cuffing right to the ear. Ávila tries to fire back. Not a lot of leverage on those shots. And there's a lot of grappling, which is sapping the physical strength, or at least the stamina, from Ávila.
Behind.
I think we had our microphone in that corner. We definitely heard the crowd. Did you hear anything?
Oh,
a big right landed by Ramirez.
Yeah, opened overhand up the ramp. Right. And that is what Ramirez's corner wanted from him. You could see Morales, his trainer, Mario Yuka Morales, throwing these overhand shots as he was talking to his fighter. We didn't have the mic in the blue corner, but we didn't need it. This is exactly what the Ramirez corner wants. Not a lot from Ávila between rounds. He looks spacey to me.
Yeah, he does. And I think Jose Ramirez's corner is seeing the flaw that Manuel has. He's dropping his right. He's dropping his left hand whenever he's shooting his jab, and that's when Jose Ramirez can shoot that looping right hand. He's landing it effectively because Manuel Villa, he's not blocking it whatsoever.
The Azteca Gym is where Jose Ramirez works out with Yuka, the trainer. Like, you've been to that gym. It is small, it is steamy, it is sticky, and there are some battles and wars that go in there. You don't just walk into that gym and be like, oh, let me get a work in here.
No, and there's guys in there with terrible records that nobody's ever heard of that will give even a world-class fighter all he can handle.
That's the kind of gym where you have one of those hot shot prospects. You're like, okay, you think you're somebody, you take them in there. It's like taking somebody to the Venice courts and like, oh, you think you play basketball? Here you go.
Right.
You
get busted. A little bit of a reality check. Different
That's
style.
A good way.
Well, I tell you what, Ramirez, he's going to get a point taken.
Uh-oh. Oh. He was already broken. Moret is going to take away a point. And that could be very huge in a fight that, for all intents and purposes, eat very hard to score.
Very critical.
And Dr. Lou Moret, former collegiate professor, does not mess around. Was after you right away. And Ramirez is trying to make up for it. Tino Ávila has yet to extend his hand. Like in baseball, you throw a hitter inside, you don't let him swing.
That's what he needs. He needs to stiff arm Ramirez, not allow him to get in close, and he needs to get on that bicycle, needs to get that lateral movement going.
Exactly, because that's his best move whenever he's moving around, creating angles, because that's how he fights. And right now he's showing that he's not been able to land effective shots on the inside. He's not even landing no body shots. He's just swinging for the fences and trying to land shots on top with Jose Ramirez.
Yeah, he doesn't have the physical strength or the style to get power on these little short shots on the inside. He needs that distance. He needs that leverage.
Especially because he's so long and rangy. There it is. But see how he's just staying there? He should have got out and created an angle.
Final seconds of the round. Another tough one to score. Another tough one to watch. And it's just rugged between Ávila and Ramirez. 10 seconds to go. Crowd get a little antsy. But this is exactly playing into the hands of Jose Ramirez.
Permanece por
pelea, tienes que presionarlo para adentro, haciendo laterales, tú, cuando lo presiones para adentro, cuando lo tengas bien, haz paso para atrás y vuelve, el ángulo derecho, upper derecha, vuela los volados, pégale abajo, súbele para arriba, negro, trabaja el cuerpo, si está trabajando, pues, ese ya está muerto, si le comienzas a pegar abajo, limpies to me, si le comienzas a pegar abajo, lo vas a noquear, pégale abajo.
It is loud inside the Belasco Theater, very loud. The boom mic is called the boom for a reason. That was loud, right, guys?
Very loud.
Good thing that Yuka is very animated, and you saw him throw an uppercut, but the last little bit, I did understand, you said if you hit him to the body, you'll be able to get to him.
It looks like Ramirez is trying to. Look at these highlights from round five, which, by the way, I scored it 9-9 even because I had Ramirez winning that round, but because of the point deduction, it is an even round.
So it's an even fight right now.
Now it's up for grabs. Two rounds apiece and one round even.
And you know this, JoJo, right now this is where the judges, three people, they're at three different locations, so they see different angles of this ruggedness. Dino Avila's never been in with a guy like this, I'll do it.
No, and it lets you know that styles and mentalities makes fights, because Avila looked his best against a Cuban amateur standout, a guy who was a former world title challenger, Yoandres Salinas,
yep.
Just last summer.
Stopped him.
He stopped this guy, and he had the look of a future top 10 contender, and against this guy, who has lost his three biggest fights, and you know, albeit against top-level opposition, Lomachenko, Mares, and Oscar Valdez, but a guy who has the record of an opponent, more of an opponent than that of a contender, or even a French contender, and he's giving Avila hell because he has a rugged style, he has a rough style. He's not even trying to box in there, and sometimes boxers have trouble with fighters.
He continues to go, talking to Ramirez yesterday at the weigh-in, he was on weight, he felt good. He's like, you're very confident. He's like, he's never faced anybody like me. I looked at his record. It's a soft, undefeated record. This is the words of Jose Ramirez.
Well, from his perspective, I mean, he's been in there with Lomachenko, who's a top 10 rated pound for pound fighter, a two division champion. He's been in there with a three division title holder in Abner Mares and Oscar Valdez, who went on to win a world title.
Abe, you sparred Ramirez. You know him very well. This has to be frustrating for Tino Avila, isn't it? And we will check in with Abe in a bit. It's frustrating for the fans right now. Abe, what do you got?
Oh, man, it's very frustrating to see, I mean, to see this, you know what I mean? But Ramirez, I guess that was his game plan because he was doing that with me when I was sparring.
This is what he was doing?
Yeah, he was doing that, but, you know what I mean, I would change angles, and as soon as the bell would ring, I would set up and hit him from the outside and keep moving. And don't let him get inside. See,
like that.
You know, let him go inside.
So is there, what does Tino have to do? He looks frustrated.
Tino needs to set, like, right now he should be getting ready to set up. As soon as he starts running in, hit him, like, he lets him go into
Yeah, Ramirez is first.
Yeah. I mean, he needs to set up from outside right there and then move.
Good observations by Abe Lopez, who fights here December 2nd. They still don't even let go after the bell. As Gerardo Ortiz's Damaso is jamming here at the Belasco Theater. Si, senor. Yo soy Damaso.
No vamos ganando. Tienes que presionar más. Tienes que hacer por ganar la pelea.
Escucha.
If you keep moving in like a bull, I'm gonna finish the fight.
Work on your fighter.
Lou Moret said, if you keep rushing in like a bull, leading with your head, I'm gonna stop this fight. And Yuka just told him, you're winning.
Now, a lot of grappling that suits Ramirez, and he is working over Avila. I scored round six for Ramirez. Avila just not able to get going, not able to establish his jab, establish distance. And I think he needs to be placing some shots to Ramirez's body to slow him down. Because Ramirez is one of these guys, he swings wide. He's there to be clipped in the face with straight punches. He could take those shots. The guys who have stopped him, they hurt him to the body first.
Exactly, and that's what I was telling Beto earlier in the fight. I was telling him that he had to dig to the body in the get-go in order to get Jose tired, because Jose, he's not going to get hurt throwing shots on top, because he's been there with guys that are punchers, and those punchers couldn't even knock him out. They had to stop him with some body shots. His body is more vulnerable than his head, and that's for sure. So Avila should have known that going into this fight, that he had to dig to the body and make sure that he gets Jose tired, and then he's going to be able to land effective shots on top.
And Lou Moret, the referee, is keeping a close eye on Ramirez. Every time he separates him, he's giving him that extra look. Like, dude, you're annoying me right now. That's the face that he has.
Ramirez might be aware of that. Now he's rubbing his head on him right now, but I think he's leery of coming in with the head. He's not rushing in the way he was in previous rounds.
He was warned.
And that's something that could be a boon to Avila. With the space, Avila can get off with that right hand and get some power behind it.
There's pockets of space.
Avila has to take advantage of him because it doesn't last long.
Tino Avila, family man now, married, has a baby on the way. Already has a name. Angelica Rose will be born in January.
Good right hand.
Overhand round. That right has been sort of the best shot landed by Ramirez all fight.
Absolutely.
Tino Avila from Vacaville, training at the Georgie Duke Sports Center. And he works 8 to 4 installing solar panels. Then he goes and works out from 5 to 8. So he hasn't made the money yet where he can get it to boxing. Wondering maybe some of that takes a toll too.
I think so.
Also,
just the focus also, just thinking about becoming a father, thinking about his first child.
Gotta provide that money. Avila does not watch videos of his opponents, but he lets his corner do that.
He might want to start doing that.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't want to tell a fighter what to do,
yeah,
how to run his career, but he might want to start peeping out his opponents just a little bit, just enough.
We get that a lot, Doug. Guys like, no, they're 4-0, 5-0. You talk to them 3 fights later. Yeah, I watched everything. I watched Ring TV Live. That's what we're here for you. But another thing, the Bay Area, it's hard to find.
Cut over the left eye of Ramirez, and it's pouring.
That Bay Area, it's hard to find quality sparring for somebody. You have to pay for somebody to come here, and he's not in the Bay Area. He's up north in Vacaville and by Sacramento. Final seconds of the round. That'll do it. Ramirez is cut, shakes his head. He paused at it, comes back. He's rugged. He's been through the wars.
Nothing new to him.
The instruction from Yuka, hit the body, work the sides, then go upstairs, telling his fighter, Jose Ramirez, you are winning.
Avila having a moment here, landing a left hook and a right hand and a soft body shot. But it seems to me like the harder shots in that round were landed by Ramirez.
A lot of Vaseline on the left eye and the cheek of Jose Ramirez, the fighter in the blue and white. Tino Avila, his name across. Full name, Manuel Tino Avila. Doug, your very unofficial scorecard, because I know it's hard to judge this kind of fight.
It is very, I have 4 rounds for Ramirez, 2 rounds for Avila, and 1 round even.
Yeah, it's hard to judge when you're focusing 100%, let alone when you're trying to do color analyst and write and take notes at the same time. I do not envy you right now.
They're just hard rounds. Some of these rounds are hard to score because, that was a nice uppercut.
But
Ramirez likes it.
But Jojo, why go back?
Yeah, exactly. He landed that shot. He should have dug to the body. I mean, dug to the body and then set up another uppercut and then followed up with the hook. seen that he landed a clean shot that he's ever landed in this fight. I don't think he's landed such a clean shot this whole fight.
That was the only one.
That was the only one, so he should have took advantage of it.
Oh, you see some. I've never seen Tino Avila this frustrated in a fight. We've done, I think, 5 of his pro fights.
Yeah, you could just tell in his eyes that he's a little frustrated. He didn't know how to fight this guy.
And give credit to Ramirez. He said, this is what I'm going to do, and I'm sticking to it. It's up to you as the A-side fighter to dictate the fight, right, Jojo?
Yes, it is. It is always, when you're the underdog, you always got to be aggressive and put that pressure on the A-side fighter because you want to showcase to the judges and to Golden Boy that you're a light dog in there and that you're able to compete with this guy and even win rounds with this guy. I mean, Jose Ramirez, I think, is doing a tremendous job being aggressive because that's how he fights.
Ramirez was living in Mexicali and 2 years ago decided to make the move to the United States, lives in Huntington Park now. Actually lives with El Gallo Gomez, that's where he's living with. And this was a fighter, like we've met these guys at the weigh-ins or our meetings. You're like, okay, you're confident. Yeah, and it's always like, yeah, I've gone up against the best. But sometimes that's some false confidence. Ramirez was like, nah, man, I am good.
He's got real character because he didn't let his setbacks define him or defeat him mentally. He used that as strength.
Well, he loses to Lomachenko in his very next fight, Abner Mares. Stopped by Abner Mares, very nice fight, Oscar Valdez.
Yeah, like, that was a tough schedule like for anybody.
Like, bro, can we get in a tune-up fight in here somewhere?
Yeah, I mean, for the best featherweights in the world, that's a tough schedule.
As Ramirez going to the wrong corner.
He's done that a few times.
He's smiling about it.
Maybe he's in the zone.
Yeah? Jojo, you ever go to the wrong corner?
No, never, man. And I hope I never planned on to.
Is that overhand right? He times it just right as he comes in. And then basically, here's a nice left to the body landed by Ramirez. He's working on the inside. Avila's trying to do more grabbing, although there was a nice 1-2 to the jaw landed by Avila. Here's how I would describe what Ramirez is doing. He's mugging Avila.
Yeah, he is. He's showing his
this is a mugging.
He's showing his man strength and that he's stronger than him and that he's able to take Avila's strongest punch. I mean, he is. He's being very aggressive in there. He's being very rugged in there and making Avila be all frustrated.
Ninth round. There is a lot on the line for Tino Avila. He says he wants to be one of the best in the 126-pound division. As we mentioned, it is loaded with Denaire and Oscar Valdez. You have Carl Frampton. You have Leo Santa Cruz there. Gary Russell has a belt. Joseph Diaz knocking on that door trying to get a world title shot.
Jesus Cuellar, WBA guy who's fighting
Abner Mares.
Yeah. And Mares, if Mares wins, he's right back in that picture.
And Tino Avila, very confident in his abilities. And, you know, I don't blame him. You get tired of fighting at the Blasco, right, Jojo? You don't want to find nothing against this place. But when you've been here a couple times, you headline, you're like, dude, I want to go to the next level. This isn't something kind of a performance that gets you next level.
No, it isn't. I mean, that's every fighter's dream is to, you know, compete at the Blasco Theater and gain that experience and then fight on bigger stages and bigger levels with tougher opponents. But you got to showcase to Golden Boy and to everybody that's in attendance that you're able to compete with those guys if you're beating these guys decisively. But tonight, it seems like Manuel Avila is not ready.
He's yeah,
not ready
I think he's on his way to losing. I mean, I think his unbeaten record is in jeopardy. The spot that he wanted to take among ranked featherweights, that is in jeopardy right now.
It's one thing when you get ranked, right? You get ranked in the top 15. That means you can qualify for.
Yeah, you're eligible to fight for a world title.
Did you put that pressure on yourself, Jojo, when you're the main event at a smaller venue? Like, okay, I know I have to put on a show.
Yes, I did. I always put that pressure on because I know that every single fight going into the ring, I know that it's going to be my toughest fight, and I got to impress every single time out. Every single fight, I got to impress more and more because. Fans are expecting it, and Golden Boy Promotions and my manager and my dad are expecting it as well. So I got to take this very seriously.
And it's one of those things, Doug, where you as a media member, you come in and you're like, okay, that guy, he can get moved up to the next level. At the same time, like, that guy isn't ready for an HBO
right.
After Dark.
The longer these prospects who are supposed to turn into contenders, the longer that they're in the game and the longer they extend their unbeaten streak, the more eyeballs are on them, the larger audience they fight in front of, and the more critics are also watching. And so there's higher expectations as they move up that ladder.
Yeah, it's one thing when you fight at 5:30. It's another thing when you're at 8 o'clock, right?
That's true.
Exactly.
Unlike the broadcasters, we know at 5:30, we always bring it. Right, Will, right, we're good to go. Ring TV Live, always bringing you the best production. Make sure you check out Bernard Hopkins in the ring with Doug Fisher immediately after this fight. With Bernard Hopkins, main event, December 17th on HBO at the Forum in Inglewood, California. Joseph Diaz Jr. will be the co-main. Final seconds of the ninth. Same way this fight started is the way the round is ending.
I think Jose Ramirez pulled it off this round, too.
Something to me, an oval is body language, and I don't want to take anything away from Ramirez, the game plan and the effort that he's put forth, because obviously that's the major factor in Tino's performance. But he seems to be lacking some kind of zip, like almost like a fighter who's either hurt his hands or a fighter who's strained to make weight and his weight depleted. Sluggish.
Yeah.
They've been telling him that he's been winning the entire fight. No real instruction here in the ninth. Doug, you're the analyst. Go for that one. I'm going to leave that one alone.
There's silence in the corner of Tino Avila. They just don't have it tonight, and his corner doesn't have answers for him. Which tells me maybe it's time for a switch up in corners.
Yeah, I think he needs another trainer, because if his trainer's not giving him advice during the rounds, that's very wrong, because every fighter should at least get some kind of say or what he should be doing the next round going into the fight, especially with such a tough fight like this tonight. To me, it seems like
another point is being deducted.
What for? I don't understand what for, man.
It was a hook, and he threw a punch. He's been warned, remember?
He's been warned for a lot of things.
Yeah, exactly. And Rhett has been yelling at him the entire time. Let's see how much more of aggression does Ramirez have, because now that you've lost the point in this round,
it's very critical for the fight.
Yeah, it didn't look like it was anything different from what's been going on since the opening round. Hey, what'd you see?
Wow, it's a dirty fight, but I think that's the game plan Ramirez had, just to do that with me, in sparring. So Dino needs to really get that space and counter right there. Boom! Don't let him come forward. Keep him at a distance.
Well, he needs to be doing that in the early rounds. It's too late. Yeah. We're in the middle of round 10, and I think Avila has just let this fight slip away from him.
Did, like you were saying before, Doug, that maybe it was something about Avila today. Maybe he hurt his hand or something, or maybe he took this opponent lightly because he's seen the losses that he fought with Lomachenko, with Oscar Valdez, and with Abner Mares, and maybe Manuel Avila thought that he was up there with those type of guys, that his skill level was as Vasyl Lomachenko or as Abner Mares. So he was.
Or maybe he assumed that those losses took something away from Ramirez,
possibly,
physically or psychologically, to where he wasn't going to face that tough version of Ramirez.
Possibly, yep.
Whatever the case, if that is the case, JoJo, shame on Tino Avila. You can't have that mentality coming into the ring.
Hey, JoJo, if you're a main event.
You're a fighter who's around the same age as these guys. This kind of opened up your eyes a little bit. Like, hey, I need to stay a different mentality.
Yeah, I got to stay very active and very focused, because this boxing game is a very brutal sport. Even your opponents, no matter what opponent you're going to be fighting, these guys are willing to win, and they're going to try to pull an upset. So you got to train hard every single fight, no matter who you're fighting.
And you can't let the B-side guy come in and dictate a fight. which is exactly what Jose Ramirez has done since the opening bell. He jumped as soon as the bell was hit to start this fight. He has not stopped smothering Manuel Tino Avila. It's going to be very interesting to see how the cards work out, as Ramirez had 2 points deducted for rough tactics. Final seconds of the fight.
No, I didn't.
As Abe Lopez called it, a dirty fight. It was just, ugh. Dragos Amargos jamming Ramon Ayala's marquee song that means the end of the night. This is one where you need Tragos Amargos, because you watch 10 rounds of this. Oh, man, clavado en el Velasco. The judges have their hands full in this one. A lot of blood coming down the eye of Jose Ramirez. Let's look at the replays. Great job by our replay staff finding some clean shots.
A decent stiff jab from Ramirez when he comes in, and then that head goes down, and he's just throwing overhand haymakers. He's able, he was consistently able to get inside without really getting clipped with a significant punch from Avila.
Yeah, he was able to dictate the pace without getting hit clean at all.
And didn't let that blood bother him at all.
Nope.
Like I said, he's a guy, he could take whatever you can dish out to the head. And as you noted, you got to hurt him to the body to take him out.
This is when I turned around to our press row, asked some of the fighters, like, hey, what do you guys got? Three of them. Shrugs.
Like, who cares? I got Ramirez.
No,
I thought he won six rounds.
Who cares? It's more of like,
what do you make of this?
Yeah. Thank you. You too. Have a good one.
As Joseph Diaz Jr. signing autographs and broadcast at the same time.
They don't leave you alone, do they, JoJo?
Hey,
you
know, I love it, though, man.
Yeah, I know you love it, but you can say no. Will Wright's going to get mad at you, bro.
Sorry about that, Will.
Nah, you're good. You're good. As we get ready to go, I think they're trying to figure it out. 2 points were deducted by Jose Ramirez. That could be huge in the way the judges have it. I have no clue how to score a fight at all.
It's now if the judges scored those rounds for Avila, those become 10-8 rounds Avila. And that could be all the difference in this fight. Yep. I thought Ramirez won those rounds that were that he received a point deduction. That was in round 5 and round 10. I had those 9-9 rounds. I had those even rounds. So I still have Ramirez up ahead.
Hey, I have Ramirez pulling it off tonight.
We'll see how that goes. The corner of Team Avila still not talking.
That's strange, man.
Well, I mean, isn't that telling, though? It's like they're not mad about the tactics of Ramirez. They're not celebrating. I think they know that they didn't bring it tonight.
Right now, just looking in this corner, do you think they won or lost?
Lost.
And Joe Martinez is standing in the ring, getting cued. What do you got, Joe? You don't know yet? 2-1-1, Joe Martinez, dale.
Señores aficionados, nos vamos a las derretas de los jueces. La señorita Carla Caiz anotó 99-89, Avila. 99-89 for Avila, the score from Carla Caiz. El señor Pat Russell anotó 95-93. Russell has it 95-93, Ramirez. Y el juez Fernando Villarreal anotó 99-89. Villarreal has it 99-89 for your winner by split decision. And still undefeated, Manuel Tino Avila.
That is a bizarre disparity. It's like the judges that scored the fight for Avila were penalizing Ramirez for the manner in which he was fighting. But here's what I say, was Avila landing punches? You gotta land punches to win these rounds. And look at Avila's face. He's not celebrating, he's not happy.
He's still undefeated.
I think he realizes he got a gift.
22-0 he is now, as Manuel Avila. It was tough, it was rugged, and a split decision for him. 6 fights were on the schedule tonight from a sold-out Velasco Theater. Pablo Rubio Jr. got it going on TV. Von Whittier against a tough fighter from Juarez, Mexico, Francisco Dominguez. Whittier 19-year-old Rubio, co-managed by Meta World Peace from the Lakers, who was here in attendance briefly as he's getting his hands wrapped. He got the win. He's now 8-0, got the unanimous decision. And the co-feature, Emilio the Kid Sanchez, Bucrema, California, got the win. He's now 14-0, but took off a tough Yul Ogin fighting the United States for the first time. Sanchez had to work, and he earned it, but he got the victory tonight. He improves to 14-0, and same night as his younger brother, Sal, got his second pro victory. And in a rough, ugly, rugged, as Abe Lopez said, dirty fight, Manuel Tino Avila gets the split decision. For Abe Lopez, Talia, Joseph Diaz Jr., Doug Fisher, and the entire crew, Beth Durant saying good night from LA.